Over the years, what I used to feel this year, drowned.
There was once a time when Igbo women were considered as one of the lowest of a family. Her life was controlled by her husband, and it was almost similar to bondage. Here, Adanne is collecting leaves to make her husband some soup to eat. Her husband, Munachiso, is out tending to the young crops. She was taught to be obedient ever since she was a little girl. As a child, her mother told her to always obey men. She served her father dinner almost every night. This was normal home life for Igbo women back in the day. In things fall apart, Achebe depicts women before colonization this way. Men, on the other hand, were treated differently, and boys were brought up to be workers on the farm or be traders. Boys go to wrestling matches, meeting, and other events with their father to learn to become an acceptable man in the community. The treatment of the genders define a part of what Igbo culture is. In present-day Nigeria, education is highly valued, and women too can get an education. So now, women aren't confined to housework and girls, and girls are free to reach for dreams other than a husband. Polygamy is practiced by certain people, and those who have accepted Christianity do not practice this polygamy. Now, women are more free to do the things they were limited before. Igbo women around the world today still follow some traditions, like that of being a supportive mother and wife, but are not brutally dehumanized or downgraded like they were in years past. Here is an Igbo woman who is educated and became a successful lawyer in London, England.
Do you take her as a lawful wedded wife?
I do.
And do you take him as a lawful wedded wife?
Husband.
You make kiss the bride.